Assalamu alaikum. Myself Farshi Shuib and I am from the Aligarh Muslim University. I am working as an assistant professor in Women's College. So my topic is completely different from this session. Yes, my topic is role of an individual in establishing peace in the society in Islamic perspective. So although my knowledge is nothing in front of these type of experts, but I am also trying to find some solutions for human problems, not by human policies, but by human with divine commands. Means the Islam's or religion's role to modify or to make an individual compatible with successful life here as well as hereafter. So there is nothing in Islam which is irrelevant for humanity and human society. So about society, Islam says it is a social system of universal character which guides scattered and split humanity to right path through the belief of oneness of God, that is Tawheed. Islam is just and balanced and true message of Allah enjoys the character of universality. It addresses to the whole humanity regardless of time and space factor and stresses on the brotherhood and humankind and their love for each other. This happy society only can be possible with individuals' efforts for each other. So Islam guides an individual's conduct in the society by giving greater emphasis on virtuous deeds. The virtuous deeds means an act done in accordingly with Allah's will or His happiness. In Islam, there is no line of demarcation in between moral life and spiritual life, means the ibadah and akhlaq. So therefore, the enlightenment of Islamic ethics is of vital importance for the coordination of the relations between members of society. As the spirit that constitutes the inner nature of man, ethics plays an important role in the mental structure of man. Islam provides two basic sources for this guidance, moral conduct and ibadah, means the prayers. These both sources have two types of affairs for human. First, his relation with Allah, and his second, his relation with the creations of God, means Allah. So, Quran says, O people of the book, there has come to you our messenger, revealing to you much that you used to hide in the book, and passing over much, there has come to you from Allah a light and a clear book by which Allah guides all who seek His pleasure to ways of salam, peace and safety, leads them out of darkness by His will to the light and guides them to a path that is straight. The second injunction of Islam is Sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who is a perfect model and ideal to be followed by Muslims. His whole life is an example of best conduct for humankind in the society. He said, you would not enter paradise until you acquire full faith. And you would not acquire full faith until you love one another. Should not I guide you to an action which I you establish among one another, you would love one another, spread the greetings of salam, peace, as much as you can among yourselves. So the major values continuously stresses by Quran and Sunnah greatly contributes for the peaceful society are justice, forgiveness, fraternity and tolerance. So justice is a supreme virtue in Islam. Islam envisages that a man should be just with all men without any discrimination. Under no circumstances, unjust is permissible in Islam. Justice is an attribute of Allah that should reflect by His creature or by men or human beings. So like truth, justice is also associate people, people to people, means man to man, and helps to maintain peace in the society. According to Quran, all mankind is a single ummah or community, and the differences that divide them are there so that they may be recognized. Justice has great significance in Islam. Moral values, Islam stresses on the importance of kind and just dealing with fellow human beings or society. The second thing is forgiveness. Islam teaches the best kind of forgiveness and answering the operations of others with kindness and mercy. Quran says, keep to forgiveness and enjoys kindness and turns away from the ignoring. Another place it says, but whosoever forgive and makes amends, his reward is from God. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam guides, God has ordered me to maintain ties with those who ties with me, and to give to those who deprive me, and to forgive those who oppress me. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his companions were so merciful in their conduct, and that instead of becoming angry with their offenders, they defend them and gave them gifts. What immeasurable acts of compassion. They went beyond human practiced unmatched generosity. They demonstrated that when we open our hearts and pardon others, we are granting ourselves an inner peace. The next virtue of man that is guided by Quran and Sunnah is fraternity. Islamic principle and thoughts are not only in harmony with the scientific facts, but it is the only religion that carries a brilliant tradition of equality and brotherhood among all human beings. Many Western scholars have accepted this fact. Agibles has explained in his following words that Muslims, they created a society more free from widespread cruelty and social oppression than any social in society had ever been in the world before. This practical side of Islam has made this religion an exclusive bearer of truth and justice. Throughout the annals of known world history, one finds Islam as the only religion that can help in the building a society based on the practiced principle of brotherhood. Next virtue is tolerance. Tolerance is one of the chief features of Islamic moral system, which promotes integration and binds human into a fraternity and establishes a society or community which shows a unity in diversity. Quran exhorts Muslim to treat the people of other religion gently and leniently. It says, and have patience with what they say and leave them with no ill. Islam does not only promote tolerance as one of the condition or a way of achieving peace in human society in general, but also encourages good behavior and respect for others and sharing of their sorrows. Islam is inclusive, not exclusive. It refers to the openness to accept others or what comes from others, or not rejecting them purely because they are from a group that appears to be different from ourselves. Inclusivity is founded on the belief that positive universal values exist in various groups and communities. Because diversity is the natural state of the universe, so tolerance becomes a foundation or fundamental teaching of Islam. This is manifested through Islam's commands to respect others' faiths, to avoid interfering in matters concerning other religions. Prohibition against any compulsion and coercion in faith or insulting other faiths, which becomes the basic for peaceful existence of various religion in the society. So I would like to conclude now my topic. Islam advocates, Islam advocates ethical and moral values for an individual to coordinate and the relationship between individuals and between individual and society. The coordination in Islamic society bound by the law, fiqh, self-discipline is carried out under the regulation of social behavior norms. It has been a common view in Islamic societies that ethics is emulate to the adjustment of interpersonal relationships. Social coordination intends to solve problems or discords that exist between individuals and individual and society. So Islam is a religion which trains its adherence with all instructions that are conditions for the establishment of a welfare of the society.